Hi students, welcome back. Now let's continue with the HTML tags. The next type of tags are the frames. So this is one of the important concept. The frames, it's nothing but it is going to divide your browser. Okay, so this is one of the important concept. The frames can display one or more than one HTML document in the same browser window. So if you are having a browser window, in this browser window you can call one or more HTML. Suppose this is a.html, I can call b.html icon. Instead of separate browsers, I can call both the files in the same web browser. Okay, so that is the use of the frame. It can display one or more than one HTML documents in the same browser. Each HTML document is called frame. So this is one frame, frame one, and this is frame two. Each HTML document is called the frame, and each frame is independent of other. So remember that there is no dependency relationship here. This is a separate file and this is a separate file. So those are two frames here. So the frame set, the tag we used is frame set. Within the tags, open and close tag, you have to write the frame set tag. This frame set tag is used to divide the browser. The main thing you have to remember that the frame set tag is always used to divide the browser. It is calling one or more, it is going to display one or more HTML documents in the same browser. And one more thing you have to remember that whenever you're using the frame set, then body tag is not required. So far, whenever you're writing the HTML, in the body only you're writing everything to display whatever that you want to be displayed on the browser. But when you're using the frame set, no need to write the body tag. Only HTML and the frame set is enough. Okay, remember that point. Now, what are the attributes that frame set consisting of? So frame set is there, and whatever the attributes that we used in the frame set. The attributes that we use in the frame set is rows, means the web browser I can divide it into rows, and columns, the browser I can divide it into columns, and frame border means each frame how much border it has to be, each frame how much border, frame border, border color also I can display color to the borders, and the name of that frame. These are all the attributes of the frame set tag. Now let's see one by one. So first, rows. So if I want to divide my web browser into rows, how, what type of attributes I need to be used? Let's see here. First, it divides, the rows is divides the browser into row wise. So here, this is a web page. This web page is 100%. Actually, whatever the web page you are taken, that web page is 100%. I'm dividing this web page into two parts. So let me call a.html. HTML, so here I'm not using the body. See here, I'm just, whenever I use the frame set, don't use the body tag. HTML, frame set, rows is equal to 30%, 70%, means total 100% I need to get here. Okay, I need to get total 100%. 30 plus 70 means 100. Okay, so 30%, I divided one frame as 30% and another frame as 70%. So browser is divided into 30 and 70. Or you can write 30, 10 star, means a browser will be divided into one frame is 30%, another frame is 10%, and star means the rest of the percent. So 30 plus 10 is 40. Still, how much is remaining? 60, because 100%, the window size is 100%. Star indicates here is 60%. So total three frames are divided. So you can divide the frames any number of size, but the target is it should be 100%, and close the frame set and close the HTML. So this is about the rows. In the same way, you can divide the browser window in column wise also. So only the difference is here you have written rows, here you have to written columns. 33%, 33%, 34%. So I divided the page into 33%, 33%, 34%. So total how much? 100% I got. So in each frame you can call different HTML files. So that is frame src source. This is a frame set. I'm not closing my frame set. So whenever I divided the column, so I want to display some files here. The HTML files will be displayed on the same browser. So for that you need to write frame source is equal to a.html. In this a.html file will be opened. In this b.html file means whatever that you have to create those files. Okay, so all files will be saved in the same folder. So just create a.html something, b.html something and c.html. So whenever you open that this frame set, this page, a message that is present in a.html will appear in this column. b.html message will be appeared in this column. And c.html message will be appeared in this column. Okay, so that's about the rows and the columns. Let me explain you some example to how it is going to be divided. Okay, so see here, I'm going to divide to design an Indian flag. Okay, by using the frame set, I'm going to design an Indian flag. So first, let's take this page, HTML, a frame set. This is my frame set. My frame set is divided into rows and columns, right? So 30%. So this is a 30% row. Okay, next is a 40%. This is 40% and still how much it is remaining? 4 plus 3, okay, 7, still 30% is remaining. So that 30% is another row. That complete 100% web page divided into 3 frames. So first, frame source. Source means whatever it has to be appeared. Frame source a.html. So whenever this message is there, it goes to that page. Already I created a.html page. So what is there in a.html page? a.html body bg color is equal to orange. Means a.html body bg color is equal to orange. The complete page is going to be appeared in orange color. Okay, so next frame source b.html. So it goes to the b.html file which I already created. So here I didn't write anything. HTML body, open body, close body, HTML. I didn't write any message. That means already default the page is white only. So it remains like this. Next source c.html. It goes to c.html file. What it is there in c.html file? HTML body bg color is equal to green. Means this source, the remaining 30%. So this is this 30%, this is 40% and this is 30%. That prints the green color. Okay. So this is how you can create the Indian flag. If you want to display Ashok Chakra here, you can write that message in this body tag. You just download that picture and save that picture in the HTML folder and just make it as a center. Okay, so just write everything on you just call that message by using a anchor tag like that. Okay, or you just call by using the image tag. No, don't write the anchor tag because anchor tag is just navigate to the another page. Just use the image tag and place that image tag, align that image tag on the center. Okay, so in this body you write the image tag and download that picture. Whatever the picture name is there, that you have to write in the image tag. So this is how you can divide the frames. You can divide the page into rows as well as the columns. Thank you.